Yeah, now I'll be dealing with an important topic called metabolism of the drug, which is also called as biotransformation of the drug. Why it is very important? Yes, because if the drugs are not metabolized properly, then there will be an adverse effect or there will be no effect or in term of therapeutic failure. I'll give a classical example. If you take a succinylcholine, a depolarizing muscle relaxant, if it is not metabolized properly, then the patient will have a lot of anesthetic complications, because succinylcholine is depolarizing muscle relaxant commonly used in induction of anesthesia. It causes the muscle relaxation and the further support is given to the ventilator. So it is metabolized by a pseudocholinesterase enzyme. It is a very short acting. Once it is metabolized, the muscle relaxation will go off, again the muscle will contract. When it is not metabolized properly, patient will have a prolonged respiratory failure and prolonged ventilator support. In the Indian subcontinent, a subset of population, Vaishya population, have this deficiency of enzyme. Hence, this drug is not properly metabolized in this particular community. Hence, in pre-anesthetic checkup, it's mandated to ask whether the patient belongs to Vaishya community or non-Vaishya community. So overall, what is biotransformation or metabolism? The process of alterations in the drug structure by the enzymes in the body is called biotransformation or drug metabolism. And the products formed after these reactions are called as drug metabolites. So why the drug metabolism knowledge is very important? I'll give a simple example. A 30-year-old female having two children, has completed her family life, weighing 60 kg, do not want to have further continuation of family. So she has approached a doctor for the contraception. The obvious contraception, usually we prefer OPD, is oral contraceptive pills, OCP, which consists of levonorgestrel and ethyl estradiol. These drugs are given 21 days in a month and 7 days gap. This will be continuing for as much she want to have a contraception. So overall, it's okay. So 30 years old mother, weighing 60 kg, complete her family, came to the OPD. She has been advised oral contraceptive pills of levonorgestrel, ethyl estradiol, and she is comfortable taking the tablets as long as she is not conceiving. Due course of this one, she has developed pulmonary tuberculosis. Obviously, when there is pulmonary tuberculosis, our drug of choice will be HRZE. That is HRZE. Isoniazid, rifampicin, pyrazinamide and ethambutol, which you usually give to the patient. It is given on weekly thrice basis. In some patients, it is given on the daily basis. So, she is taking oral contraceptive pills. At the same time, she is taking anti-tuberculosis drugs. After 4 months of the treatment, she has come to the doctor with complaints that she has missed period. And upon evaluation, she is found to have urine for pregnancy test positive. It means, in spite of she is taking oral contraceptive pills, she has conceived the pregnancy. What is the reason? Are the oral contraceptive pills not working, or something has happened, or a drug interaction or drug metabolism reaction between ATT versus oral contraceptive pills? You know, oral contraceptive pills are metabolized by cytochrome enzymes. And among the ATT, if you take rifampicin, is an inducer. So what has happened? Rifampicin is an inducer of the cytochrome enzymes. So it has induced the enzyme. Ultimately, the oral contraceptive pills are over-metabolized and there is no steady state levels of oral contraceptive pills in the blood. Hence, there will be no therapeutic effect, which resulting in the therapeutic failure of the oral contraceptive pills due to the rifampicin induced cytochrome P450 enzyme.